Hello friends and welcome to this video. We are with the last video of the 10th chapter that is titled Morphological Image Processing. The subject is Digital Image Processing. So in this Morphological Image Processing, one of the fundamental tasks of Digital Image Processing, we have first of all seen what exactly the morphology mean, and based on to this understanding, the fundamental morphological image processing operations as like the erosion and dilation we have understood, and afterwards the two those have been derived by the use of erosion and dilation, those are opening operation, closing operation. We have seen various properties of the morphological operations we have understood, along with the MATLAB demonstrations, the hit or miss transformation, and another applications of morphological image processing. So based on to the understanding that we have made for most possibly the fundamental morphological image processing operations, we have a problem to practice, and after that we can start with a new chapter. So let us begin with the miscellaneous problem. So here we start with our topic, the topic titled miscellaneous problem. The problem statement is given to us. The problem statement starts with a binary image denoted by capital X and the structuring element given to as follows. We have been provided these two, capital X here and capital B here. So the binary image capital X is represented on the left hand side bottom, whereas the structuring element is denoted by capital B here on the right hand side. Now in this problem statement, we have to find answers to the six questions. So these are the sub questions of this miscellaneous problem. In the part one, we need to calculate x to the power c, it means the complement of the binary image capital X. Next to that, we need to calculate y1, which is having x dilated by the structuring element B here. Next to that, in part C, we need to calculate the image denoted by Y2, where we have the erosion of complement of X by the same structuring element B. In the fourth, we need to calculate Y3, the output image, the erosion of X by the same structuring element B. In the fifth one, we need to calculate Y4 image as the output of dilating the complement of the binary image X. And in the sixth, we have been asked what is the relationship between Y3 and Y4. So let us find solutions to all the six sub questions here. So as the first sub question, we need to calculate X to the power C complement. So here we have a visualization of X, the given binary image. So here we have the total 12 pixels represented with the complete darkness, whereas the rest of all the pixels are there in white color here. So here we are having the 6 rows and 6 columns, so total 36 pixels. So if we make the white pixels black and black pixels white, it will be the calculation of X to the power C, the complement of the given binary image here. So in this complement operation, we have the input image as utilized from the given data, and we output image as the complement XC denoted on the right hand side here. So see, whatever the white pixels were there, now they are completely dark, and the completely dark pixels are completely white here. So this is the complement of X here, denoted by X to the power C. So this is the answer to first part. In the second part, we were asked to find the image Y1, which is obtained by the dilation operation of X by the structuring element B here. So here we have the input image X and the dilation here we perform. So this is the corresponding output here. So y1 is equal to x dilated by b. So comparatively, you can see there were initially only 12 pixels with the complete dark color, and because of the dilation, so whatever the object area I can say in the image plane that it was completely dark with 12 pixels, so it has got enlarged here. So here we have more number of dark pixels, and this enlargement is on all the possible directions: upward, downward, left hand side and right hand side. So this is the answer to part 2 of the question here. So calculation of y1, the x dilated by the structuring element b. Here the structuring element b is symmetric, here the origin is at the center here. So here we have the dilation leading to expansion of the input image. Now we focus on finding answer to part 3. In the part 3, we needed to make calculation for y2 as the image obtained by erasing the complement of x here. So the complement of x we have provided as a solution to part 1 here. So if we erode that particular image with the given structuring element, we get the resultant image here, and the result of the operation is that we have all the pixels with white color, no pixel is there with dark color here. So this is answer to part C here, or part 3 here. Now next is the fourth part, where we need to calculate y3, which is obtained by eroding the input image x, binary image, by the same structuring element b here. So here we have the erosion of the input image x by the structuring element b, and the result of the operation is that we have only 2 pixels with the dark color, whereas the rest of all are white here. So as we know that erosion is opposite procedure to that of the dilation. In the dilation we have observed expansion of the image object, whereas shrinking is there in the erosion operation here. So here we can also term the erosion operation to be anti-expansive here. So it is compressive operation here. Now this is the solution to part 4 of the question. Next to that, we require to answer part 5. In the part 5, we are required to calculate y4 as the image, which is dilated version of the complement of x by the structuring element b here. So the complement of x we have found in the first part here, so that we can utilize, and we will perform the dilation by the structuring element b, and here it is the corresponding result here. So here we find only 2 pixels with the white color, whereas all the rest of other pixels are there in dark color here. And in the last part, part 6, we were asked to find the relationship between y3 and y4. So if we carefully observe the outputs into y3 and y4, we come to see that whatever the pixels were there in white color for y3 are there in black color in y4, and the same reversal is true. So therefore, to see the relationship between y3 and y4, we can write y3 is equal to y4 complement, or y4 is equal to y3 complement here. So this was our miscellaneous problem, and with this problem we are finished with the chapter number 10, morphological image processing. By the next lecture in our subject digital image processing, we are going to start with a new chapter, and thereupon image segmentation we are going to address. The first topic of the chapter is what is image segmentation. Thank you.